It's the 203rd anniversary of the Battle of New Orleans. There's a remarkable story coming from the FBI about the recovery of a rifle that we used during the original fight. That rifle was stolen decades ago from a local museum. It ended up in the hands of a private collector until authorities recently tracked it down. Lauren Bale brings us the story.
It's a date that historians say is forgotten.
January 8th. 1815.
On this day, more than 200 years ago, a group of ragtag soldiers defended New Orleans from the British. The battle took place on this field in Chalmette and marked a turning point for the U.S.
American history begins to change world history.
Volunteers at the Chalmette battlefield say visitors are often unaware of this field's significance.
It doesn't have the prominence that it once did.
Today, a piece of this history returned home, and volunteers hope it will inspire a new generation to appreciate their own backyard. FBI agents, with the help of the Louisiana State Police, recovered a rifle from the Battle of New Orleans that was stolen 35 years ago. It's the only rifle in existence that can be traced back to the Chalmette battlefield.
As a result of their dedication and perseverance, a significant part of New Orleans history has been recovered and now placed back on display to the visitors to this museum.
The rifle was owned by William Ross, who defended New Orleans during the War of 1812. His grandson donated the rifle to the Confederate Memorial Hall Museum in 1894, where it remained until it was stolen in 1983. Now the historic rifle has been returned to the museum, and historians say a piece of the past will live on.
It's local history, it's our history.
Lauren Bale, Eyewitness News.
The rifle will be on permanent display at the Confederate Memorial Hall Museum on Camp Street.